Last time I asked you to jot down one or two situations or people that trigger your anger. So much so that when you think about it, you get angry all over again. Anybody got... Let's give Bradley a chance this time.
My partner parked me in again. I couldn't find the keys. I had to wake him up, and he starts yelling at me.
Describe the feelings.
I think...
My stepkids do that all the time. They leave their bikes in the middle of the garage, and if I want to pull in, I got to get out and move the bikes with a car full of groceries.
Doris, catch it! Keep Billy's bike out of the driveway!
It was a famous commercial from the 60s. Bufferin. Guy has a headache, and he takes it out on his wife.
Back to Bradley. I'm trying to get into his actual physical sensations of anger.
He saw red. Who wouldn't?
She's right. I mean, why is he isn't here? Why isn't his roommate in therapy for selfishness issues?
There are always going to be things out there that are irritating and annoying and out of our control. What we can control is our response to those triggers.
So people just get a free pass, the whole world.
I told you about my supervisor checking my work and nobody else's. I wonder why.
Because you're a minority?
Exactly. That's why I'm in here.
Uh-huh.
You seem angry about Evelyn's problem.
It makes me mad.
It doesn't make you mad. You make you mad.
I come from a biased family, but I was different. I put all my faith and my hopes into the civil rights movement. I left home and I marched. And for what? So they could ride around in their SUVs blasting that rap shit? And you can't say anything because they might have guns?
Wait a fucking minute. Who's they?
If the shoe fits.
This is fucking priceless.
Okay, let's not time travel here. Let's try to stay in the present. Janice, you're angry. Let's stay with that. What are your actual physical feelings right now?
I'd like to punch in the face.
Your hands are clenched. Did you realize that?
You're provoking me to make a point, and maybe that's your job, but I don't like it.
Look at you. You're not even listening.
Hello, he's talking to me.
No. You and me, we do most of the talking in here. The man is trying to say that those people outside, they do the thing, but we're the ones that get all upset and start carrying on. That's all he's saying.